I have expressed our country's desire to work with you, but I appreciate you recognize the fact that the future of your country is in your hands.
In my judgment, Maliki has got what it takes to lead a unity government.
These pictures won't help the White House. Iraq's Prime Minister Maliki was forced today to ask anti-American militia leader Moqtada Sadr for help quelling the sectarian violence. A Republican strategist close to the White House says there is, quote, great concern in the administration about Maliki's competence.
Stopping the violence between the Shiite majority and Sunni minority is proving nearly impossible.
Hospitals have become command and control centers for the Mehdi Army militia. Sunni patients are being murdered, some dragged from their beds.
Meanwhile, in Iraq, questions persist about whether the Iraqi government is up to the challenge of uniting the country and ending the violence.
Iraqis say the problem starts at the top with Nouri al-Maliki, the Shiite prime minister. When Maliki came to power 5 months ago, he promised to bring Sunnis and Shiites together. Today, he appears to be serving only Shiite interests. In September, he supported a controversial law that Sunnis fear will shut them out of Iraq's oil wealth. 2 weeks ago, Maliki ordered the release of a captured Shiite militia leader. And yesterday, he told the U.S. to remove checkpoints around the stronghold of Shiite militia leader Moqtada al-Sadr.
President Bush today voiced frustration and impatience with Iraq's embattled Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki. Yesterday, the chairman of the Senate Armed Services Committee, Democrat Carl Levin of Michigan, called for Maliki's ouster. President Bush did not go nearly that far today, but he was far from supportive. Our chief White House correspondent, Martha Raddatz, is in Washington.
For months, the president has touted Maliki as, quote, the right guy for Iraq. But today, for the first time, President Bush said Maliki could be replaced.
If the government doesn't respond to the demands of the people, they will replace the government. That's up to the Iraqis to make that decision, not American politicians.
Mr. Bush's remarks were careful, but analysts who track the president's Iraq policy say the message was clear.
I think Mr. Bush made a very significant change in his policy today. He made it clear that his support for al-Maliki is on very thin ice.
And the chief of staff of the Army, General George Casey, told ABC News today that commanders in Iraq have told him they are not optimistic about the Maliki government, and neither is he, saying, quote, the military makes gains and these guys just fritter it away. The former counselor to Secretary of State Rice says a plan B is now likely being considered.
I can confidently guess that our government is quietly speculating about a lot of different options, knowing how much concern Iraqis have about their leadership.